direct ophthalmoscope. In this, the image formed is virtual, erect and 15 times magnified, and area of retina visualized is about 2 disc diopters. In this image, you can see direct ophthalmoscopic examination. Binocular indirect ophthalmoscope. Here the image formed is real, inverted and 4 to 5 times magnified. Area of retina visualized is about 8 disc diopters. And in indirect ophthalmoscope, we use about 20 diopters biconvex lens. In this image, you can observe indirect ophthalmoscopic examination. Uses of indirect ophthalmoscopy is to visualize peripheral retina up to ora serrata, and it is an investigation of choice to diagnose retinal detachment. Slit clamp. It is used to examine anterior segment of the eye, that is conjunctiva, cornea, iris, lens and anterior vitreous body. In this image, you can observe slit clamp examination. Tachymeter. It measures corneal thickness. Keratometer. It is used to measure curvature of cornea for estimating corneal astigmatism. Keratometer Myers. Myers means 3 circles. Here we look into keratometer and refine the alignment of the image into Myers, that is 3 circles on patient's cornea. Keratoscope or Placido disc. It is used for corneal topography. Corneal tropography. It is gold standard for screening of keratoconus. Goldman 3 mirror gonio lens. It is used for examination of angle of anterior chamber. Here pupil dilatation is not required as it hampers proper visualization of the angle. In this image you can observe gonioscopic examination. Schiotz tonometer. Goldman's applantation tonometer. It is a gold standard in measuring intraocular pressure. Rebound tonometer. It is a choice for self-monitoring or home tonometry and can be used without anesthetizing the eye. Tonopen. Sisler-Jackson cross cylinder. It is used for subjective refinement of cylinder. It uses a toric lens or spherocylindrical lens of minus 0.5 diopter sphere with plus 1 diopter cylinder. Duochrome test chart. It is used for subjective refinement of sphere. In this test, we ask the patient to read the letters on both red background as well as green background. If the letters in both red and green background are equally clear, then we interpret it as emmetropia. If the letters in the red background is more clear than that of green background, then we interpret as myopia. If the letters in the green background are more clear for the patient than in red background, then we interpret as hypermetropia. Pinhole test. Here, if the visual acuity improves with pinhole, we interpret it as refractive error. If the visual acuity doesn't improve with pinhole, we interpret it as ocular pathology. If the visual acuity decreases with pinhole, then we interpret it as macular pathology. Retinoscopes. They are for objective measurement of refractive errors. Self-illuminated streak retinoscope. Priestley-Smith's retinoscope. Reflecting mirror retinoscope. Snellen's chart. K-picture test chart. Broken wheel test chart. Ishihara test. It is used to screen for congenital protanopia, which is red color blindness, and congenital deuteranopia, which is green color blindness. Farnsworth-Munsell 100 hue test. Despite its name 100 hue, it only contains 85 hue caps. It is the most sensitive test for both congenital and acquired color blindness. It is used to detect dichromatism, that is absence of one type of cone, because it can detect all the three types of color blindness. Farnsworth lantern. Holmgren's wool test. Nagel's anomaloscope. It is the most accurate test for severity of color blindness. Optical coherence tomography. In the first picture, you can see optical coherence tomography showing macular edema. In the second picture, you can appreciate optical coherence tomography showing subretinal fluid. Maddox rod. It is used to measure heterophoria at far fixation, also for macular function test. For diagnosis of cyclotropia, we use double Maddox rod. Maddox wing. It is used to diagnose heterophoria in near fixation. Synaptophore. It is a haploscopic type of instrument. That is, haploscopic means presenting one image to one eye and another image to other eye. It is also known as major amblyoscope. It is used for the diagnosis of horror fusionis. Horror fusionis is nothing but congenital strabismus with harmonious anomalous retinal correspondence. Syntonic phototherapy. It is used for the treatment of amblyopia. Lensometer. Remember that lensometer measures vertex power but not focal length of unknown lens. It only measures vertex power, which is reciprocal of distance between back surface of lens and its secondary focal point. This distance is known as back focal length. Computerized auto refractometer. Worth 4 dot test. It is done for binocular vision. You can observe red-green goggles. Perimetry. It is used for the assessment of visual function throughout the visual field, for the detection and analysis of damage along the visual pathway, and monitoring of disease progression. Types of perimetry. Lister's perimeter. Goldman's perimeter. Humphrey's automated perimetry. In this image, you can observe fluorescein stain strips. Strimmer's test filter paper. It is the test used for measuring tear quantity, that is aqueous level. National Program for Control of Blindness. Criteria for blindness according to National Program for Control of Blindness is inability of person to count fingers from distance of 20 feet or 6 meters. Remember that from August 25th to September 8th, we call it as National Eye Donation Fortnight. For 2019, the theme for National Eye Donation Fortnight is Light Up a Life and Donate Your Eyes. Every second Thursday of October, we celebrate World Sight Day. For 2019, the theme is Vision First. Vision 2020, The Right to Sight. Partners of Vision 2020 are WHO, Orbis, and IAPB. This image is femtosecond assisted laser cataract surgery. In this femtosecond assisted laser cataract surgery, we use neodymium glass laser of 1053 nanometers wavelength. It works via a principle called photodisruption and is used to create corneal incisions, anterior capsulotomy, and lens fragmentation. This picture shows ND YAG laser. It is the most widely used procedure for after cataract, that is posterior capsular cataract. Complications of NDR laser are cystoid macular edema and retinal detachment. Contraindications of NDR laser are one-eyed individuals, any history of retinal detachment, and pre-existing cystoid macular edema.